Isn't it dangerous allowing this filthy discharge to collect so close to the core?
We can use the flow to drive the turbines. There will always be a torrent of excreta flooding through these tunnels. We can use this to supplement the steam production and ensure constancy.
God, the stench! This fecal matter is the true product of the age.
Thank you. we can save them. We can set them free. We can replace a rotten old world with a clean new one.
Mr. Madness, you sound every bit the fanatic.
Well, how can I be otherwise, Professor? How can any man of ethics simply stand by and watch this world drown in its own excrement?
And your engineer, this visionary with whom you embarked upon this course, does he share your views?
Indeed he does. Indeed he does. The poor fellow has seen it all before. Now, this is not the first great civilization he has wept for.
And so you said about things as you appear upon your turn.
Naturally. These things cannot be left to rot upon the tree. And sponsors were remarkably easy to find. I tell you, Professor, a trail of greed brings rich men to your door like pigs to truffles.
Thank you.
You seem to have undergone quite a profound conversion in Mexico, Mr. Lander.
You could not have seen it yourself and not, Professor. As we disembarked, even through my fever, I saw the detritus of this so-called progress. I saw starvation and disease, rot and destruction polluting the waters of the Empire. We are ruinous, you and I, and all of us, and we make the world unclean.
And you took it upon yourself to act as Redeemer.
Professor, I would not be so presumptuous. I am merely a conduit. I am constructing an architecture to wrestle our damnation to the ground and smother it with steam.
Trickled to still waters. I dragged myself deeper into the temple, downward ever, towards a wind that held the voices of my children, beckoning me to set them free.
place, and then you went into the house and gathered the servants and reset you and I on recrafting them. And then you went into the garden and buried those tiny shattered skulls alone. For your children, Magnus, to spare them the world you have created for us all. And they feel no pain. The process is completely humane.
Humane, Professor? That we judge the acceptable level of suffering by the human condition? Ask the beggar, Professor. Ask the orphan. Ask the whore. Ask the starving, Professor. The weak, the sick, the filthy. Ask them to define your humane.
this thing. Their mortal faces turn to madness. They suffocate. They suffocate. I will rise to bleach the sky and still the water. I will spin the world wheel and set the future upon the path to redemption.
Where are my children? You promised me my children.
My time is come. More pig. More pig.
Boys. Boys. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Emerging, I raised my head to an uncaring sun, and I cursed this world of pain and despair. This civilization built on the ricketed bones of the unfortunate, on the greed and swell of mammon and empire. Cradling a stone egg in my jacket, I kissed my children farewell, and I crawled my way home.
Thank you.
Commanders. You know the arms so well enough. A cleansing fire always burns, little Mandus, but it purifies and it makes anew. Did it hurt to carve out the fevered flesh? Did it hurt to cut free the gangrenous foot? Ask instead this. Can we save them?
When did I say that? That is not me. That is not me!
please! Kill them all!